back up in this thing. First off, let me get a shout out. Whoever this YouTube beat is, you know what I'm saying? I think bang, no. You dig? This one right here, though, this for the strip jump. You know what I'm saying? Pumping in your trunk. You dig? Well, it's the Big Macadocious. All right, sipping
Remy on the Bronx. Get the. That's that joint right there, man. What's good, y'all?
Hello, this is Am.
It's your boy Ace.
And we are
Young Married and Lit. What it do, what it do.
Thank y'all for continuously watching us.
Appreciate it.
So yeah, I want to first of all thank all of our listeners. Thanks all of our subscribers, supporters.
Appreciate y'all.
We appreciate y'all for continuing to support us. Mm-hmm. And yeah, let's get it started. We're going to dive right in. So for this episode, I always say we really ain't got a topic because we really don't. But I just kind of want to like at least have something to go off of. So I figure I just been seeing a lot of stuff on social media about like commitment. Like if you talk to somebody, what to expect, if you're dating, if you're married. And we kind of just want to go over that to start off with. You know, we're going to start off with us asking each other how our week went. So, babe, how did your week go?
It was cool. It was cool. I was very eager to get back to, you know, to this. And this has definitely become somewhat therapeutic. I enjoy this a lot, yeah, man. You know, when you first brought it to me, I was like, I don't know.
Yeah, but he was not fucking with Young Married and Lit. Like, man,
it wasn't that I wasn't fucking with it, man. It was just, you know, I'm not used to, you know.
He don't like for people to be in our business. And he don't like for...
That ain't true. I mean,
that's very true.
It is kind of true.
That's true, because it's true for me too. But I had to like explain to him like what I felt like I wanted the podcast to be. Mm-hmm. And once we went over everything, I was like, it's not really a fact of us like putting our business out there. It's just really like for us as well as other people, just letting them know like you can be young, you could be married. You don't have to like... be this fucking cookie cutter marriage or like, yeah, you know, just do what you feel like society is supposed to say you're supposed to be because you're married. So that was really the whole thing of Young Married and Lit.
Yeah.
So all in all, you had a good week?
Yeah, it was cool. It was cool. How about you, wife?
I had a really good week. It was cool. I just did what I normally do, come to the store, make some money, you know, because that's what I like to do.
Clap it up for making
clap
money.
It up for making money.
Get the monies.
Make
that money.
I got a little time to myself, got a little rest. Yeah, and that was pretty much it for me. It was a great week, I would say. It was cold. It's cold as fucking St. Louis.
It's cold as hell, man.
Like, I don't understand why it's so cold.
But would you rather it be cold with the snow?
No.
Okay, then.
Because you know how, yeah.
Man.
I can't drive in the snow. I don't like driving in the snow. And I'm happy it ain't no snow. Then we had that snow, was it like last week?
Mm-hmm.
It was last week or this week. And it was like 3 inches or something like that. I was just praying that it didn't stick. And God, thank you. I appreciate that. Because I cannot drive in the snow. And it just makes me so nervous to drive. And even Ace, he's a great driver. But at the same time, like... driving in the snow, it just, I don't know, it just do something to me. That's something I don't like to do. So let's go right into it. So we want to talk about, again, the stages of commitment. I would say the first stage is, of course, just like meeting. Like,
mm-hmm.
We met on Twitter.
Yep.
Ace slid in my...
Clap it up for Twitter. Clap it up for Twitter.
He slid in my DMs. But look, we got to talk about, yeah, I think we always talk about how you slid in my DMs, but we didn't talk about, like, before, like, what kind of led you to sliding in my DMs. And I think it was, like, I don't know how I was following you and all your friends, like, because I was kind of new to Twitter.
Because I was lit on Twitter.
You was lit on Twitter. I was like, oh, okay, he got a little something. But, yeah, I was just following all of y'all. They was following me and stuff. And I used to tweet you all the time. I thought you was real. I thought you was real, like, down to earth. And, like, you was cool. Like, you just had, like, this little...
I passed you that. Put some ice in there for me.
Babe, let me... Okay, I'm going to put some ice in there. But, you know, I can't really do two things at once.
Yeah.
Like,
she put some ice in my cup.
You're going to have to do it yourself.
What? It's just putting ice.
Where is the ice at?
It's right there. Oh, don't worry about it. I'm sorry. Yeah, back to schedule. I'm sorry.
Like, where is the ice? It's not over here. I don't understand.
My bad.
But yeah, anyway, so yeah, I was just on Twitter and we was following each other. I thought Ace had like 2 or 3 kids and I was not.
I don't know where
that
she
nigga,
got
like,
that from. To this day, she brings that up. And
I was
like
nah, he got kids and I wasn't trying to be no stepmama. I wasn't trying to be like, I ain't gonna, you know what, I ain't gonna even say that on this podcast, because then I'm gonna have some people be in their feelings and I'm not into that today. I'm not here for that today. But yeah, you know, we was just on Twitter and we was tweeting each other and like, what was your perspective? Because I feel like, what did you think about me? Like, why did you want to talk to me?
I wanted to talk to you because I thought you was pretty.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought you really, you know, had a good ear for music.
I did. Like, I still do.
You knew a lot of the songs and stuff that me and my friends used to listen to. And a lot of them songs wasn't like all that, like, you know.
Like.
Treated women good songs. You know what I'm saying? It was some ratchet shit.
Yeah.
But you liked a lot of that stuff. I'm like, man, she know all of them songs. She would quote the lyrics and the words all the time. I was like, wow. She real hip.
It was like. I don't know, like back then I was a loner. Like I'm a loner now, but back then I was a loner. So all I had was really just like music. So I would just like look up certain things or like see what was popular. I used to be on Dat Piff and
Dat Piff.
Yes, I used to be on Dat Piff. What was the other one?
Live mixtapes.
And
yeah.
Then like when Twitter, like when I got on Twitter, that's when it was like, you know, the Wiz Khalifa, the Currencies, the Mac Miller, like all of that.
What a
time to be alive. We talked about that on the last episode. But yeah, it was just like, I don't know. I feel like you was giving me good vibes. And like at that point, I was on like a fuck nigga stage. Like I was like, fuck these niggas. I ain't talking to nobody. I'm good. Like I'm finna be single. I was having a hot girl summer.
Oh, that's what you thought.
Clap it up for the hot girl summer I had. Yes, because I did have that before you, Buddha. Before you. It was cool, though. But yeah, that's how we met. So I feel like the meeting stage is literally just meeting this person, just, you know, figuring out, like, what you like about them or why you may be attracted to them. It could be physical. It could be mental, spiritual, whatever. So I feel like that's really the first part of commitment. The second part is a little iffy because I feel like people be saying, like, yeah, I used to talk to this person, which is like, what do you consider talking? Like, what is talking to somebody? What is to be expected?
That's crazy because that's like a thing. Like
it is.
I feel like talking to somebody is literally just that, and that's all it is. You talking to somebody, you getting to know them, you starting to figure them out. I mean, that's even if you get that far.
Okay,
you know?
So if you just talking to somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Or you like
maybe
still...
you texting them, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Good morning. You know how niggas be, you know, good morning, beautiful. Grand rising queen.
He's sending it to about 5 other bitches too, though. Right. So don't feel too special. But I could agree. Like the talking stage is, but you know, like some women, when we say we talking to somebody, that may mean like we don't talk to other people or we just maybe just focusing on you. But like the dudes, I feel like when y'all say y'all talking to somebody, it's literally just y'all feel like y'all just talking. But y'all still be trying to fuck though. So it's like if you talking to somebody and you have sex,
hey,
like
man, nigga got knees, man.
No, women do too. But I'm saying like if you in a talking stage and y'all have sex or whatever, like I feel like at that point, it might go to the next level. Like, do men think like that? Or what do y'all think?
I mean, it depends. It depends, you know. It depends if that's someone that we want to settle down with or we want to take that leap, you know.
And this is literally talking. Like, I don't even know if we at the first date stage. Are we at the first? I feel like talking at first date kind of like intertwined with each other.
Yeah. It's kind of like together.
Listen, my question, I always be seeing this on like Instagram and stuff like that. Who is supposed to plan the first date?
Man, I want to say the man, but at the same time though, man, women be so picky, man. Like they be so picky these
days.
But
that's the thing though.
But look though, let me finish. A lot of guys would want to do that, but they might not because, you know, Yeah, I be picky sometimes. You know, you don't want to make her feel like you ain't got class or you ain't up to her standards. You know, you might, you know, you might say, you know, let's go to the park, you know, have a picnic or something. And, you know, and the whole time he was thinking about, you know, going to a concert. And you probably like, no, that ain't the perfect vibe. But, you know, that's the thing. Tomato, tomato, you know, to each his own. You
know? I feel like this. Let me tell you something about women. We love a nigga that plans. Like, plan a date for us. Like, if you in the talking stage or if you dating somebody right now, plan the date. I mean, to the T, like, okay, text us and say, yeah, can you be ready at 8 o'clock? And we might not even ask you where we going or what's going on. We just like, damn, this nigga told me to be ready at 8 o'clock. That is also just like a good thing too, because y'all niggas don't be planning nothing. Like, it's just like y'all go with the flow. Like, we don't want to go with the flow all the time. We want y'all to take initiative to be like,
stuff.
Yeah, I'm planning stuff. We 11 years deep in this, babe.
Yeah. You know that meme with Elmo driving the car in the car, and they like, your girl, when you tell her to ride with you. That's you.
No, I'd be happy as hell.
Happy as hell. Elmo is in that shit.
I know exactly what you're talking about, because I always be saying it on Instagram too. Like, we love a nigga that be like, you want to ride with me? I don't know. It's just something about that. Like, then when you get in the car, like, I'm in a passenger seat and you driving and you put that arm up, like, yeah, like that's something like that. That yeah, does something
give that
to
grain.
Us.
Giving that grain. Y'all
that,
be dying for it.
That does something to us. I ain't gonna lie. We be dying for it. But you gotta be a nigga that got like swag and stuff like that. Like, you can't be lame and doing that, because we ain't gonna really fuck with it like that. But yeah, I would say like the man needs to plan the date. Like, that's what.
So
I would
you
say.
Think the man needs to plan the date?
Yes.
Okay. So what
like,
if the
make
man,
a plan?
What if the man plans the date and the woman is like, nah? She like, nah. I'm not really into that. You know.
Then what happens? 9 times out of 10,
that's not a trick question, by the way. I'm literally just asking.
No, I'm telling you, like, 9 times out of 10, like, we just happy that you're taking initiative to actually plan something for us.
Okay.
So you don't even really have to go into detail. Like, you can tell us to dress up, dress down, something like that. But we love to not know what's going on, like, as far as like a date goes. Like, just tell us to dress up, tell us to wear tennis shoes, like, you know, stuff like that. But we love a plan, so I don't think any women would disagree with that. Now, if it's something we really want to do after we've like maybe went on a couple of days, got to know each other, something like that. If it's something we want to do, we might say, "Hey, I want to do this," and then you could plan it that way. But like, for the most part, first, second day, like, we won't try to plan. Like, plan us, take us to, you know, take us to E. Like, you could take us shopping too. I mean, hey, I don't know, do something like Lord. That. On the first
day. It ain't tricking if you got it, you know what
that's
I'm saying?
True.
Hey.
Like, clap it up. Clap hey, it up man. For that. Hey.
You did.
But yeah, I would say like the first 2 dates, I feel like y'all should plan flat out. And then like, you know, the third day, like, I feel like, okay, you know, we getting to know each other. I could take you out on a date. I'ma surprise you. Like, let me do something for you, but that's just me. So like, that's something that I would do. And I feel like, okay, so as far as, like, in this first date stage, when it comes to sex, like, let's just say you meet somebody, like, on a Tuesday, and on Friday, y'all go on a date. If y'all have sex that night, like, do y'all judge us? Like, would y'all judge us if we decided to, like, date, like, have sex with y'all? Like, do y'all be thinking
that? It depends on, you know, what's going on. It's like, if we just, you know, messing around, you know.
We just cool,
you know, then that's one thing, you know, but
I'm
gonna be real with you. Most dudes not gonna really sleep with no girl on the first night that they see a future with, you know what I'm saying?
Nah.
I don't know, you know what I'm saying? From my perspective, how I feel about it, I wouldn't, you know, like, if I was really into you,
if the girl throwing the pussy, you catching it, period.
I mean, I might catch it, but that don't mean I'm gonna keep it. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm talking about.
Church. Hey, I'm just saying though.
That's what I'm saying. Like, so basically what you're saying is you're judging her because she's giving it up to you on the first date, right?
I'm not judging her. I'm talking about, listen, if you into a woman and y'all, let's just say you just meeting a woman and y'all do, you might not consider her wifey material right off the bat. Mm-hmm. You might be like, okay, she cool, you know, might see where this go, might drag it out a little bit longer. Mm-hmm. But, you know, had y'all met on different circumstances, you know, y'all might, you know, you might instantly have that vibe. Like, you know what, dang, like, I think I can really, you know, be with her.
Okay. I can see that. So, babe, you remember, our first day, we went to fucking Rod House. Like,
Rod! Man, shout out to Mama Natalie, man. That's a delicious meal, man.
What we have, like, meatloaf or something?
Man, Mama Natalie. So, look, when I first took Amber out, man.
Where you come get me from?
I came and got you from Alcott. I came to Walnut Park.
Yeah, and it was all my cousins.
Like a real nigga.
All my boy cousins was like, who is this nigga? Like,
yeah.
Yeah, what?
That was me. I was over there, yeah.
You came and got me.
Shout out to Walnut Park,
yeah,
man.
Shout out to Walnut Park.
But yeah, I came and got you from Walnut Park, mm-hmm. and we slid back to the south, took you over Mama Natalie house, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? Chilling with Rod, you know, she was
Why would you take me to your friend's house?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I just young nigga shit, man.
We was young
as
hell.
Young and broke.
We was 2021.
Something like 2021
when we first met. So don't think we saying like he took me to his friend's house for the first day when we 32. Like, nah, he was young as hell. We was broke as hell too. So, but I had great time. Like, I thought Ace was just such a gentleman. Like, he was so nice, y'all. He had his little braces and stuff. And I was like, oh, he's so cute.
She always bringing up them braces.
Babe,
like,
I love, because the thing is, I couldn't tell that you had braces on Twitter.
You thought I had a grill? No.
I don't know. Like, I don't think that I, like, really paid attention that, like, that deep. But, like, so when I first, like, when you first came to see me the first time I saw you in person, you had braces. And I was like, damn, this nigga got braces.
Oh, man.
I felt like you take care of yourself, like. Niggas don't be had back. Niggas ain't had braces back then. Like, I'm just saying, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just feel like you took care of yourself, and that was something new for me. Like, I wasn't used to that. Like, I wasn't used to that. So that was just very, like, I always remember that. So that's why I always talk about it.
Okay. shout out to Mama Ace, man.
Shout out to
Mama Ace
shout
with
out
that
to my
A1 insurance, baby.
Yes, shout out to my mother-in-law.
For sure.
I love you, Kitty. Okay, so we already talked about the first day, who paying, who planning.
Mm-hmm.
Then the next thing was the talking stage. Because I feel like you talk before, like, to get to know that person. Then, you know, after you start dating for a while, and y'all still talking, but you kind of in a, like, a, maybe a weird position. Maybe the woman wants to be in a relationship. Maybe you don't, or vice versa. So
mm-hmm.
how do you, like what... How do you even have that conversation? Like, how do you go from the talking stage to actually dating? Like,
I'm gonna just jump right in and say it, man. Real talk. Am I lying when I say this? Mm. It usually comes from an argument.
Yeah,
it comes
true,
from an
yeah.
argument. It comes from somebody, one of y'all mm-hmm. seeing the other person do something and you feel a way about it.
Yep.
And then y'all had a... So what we doing then? what we at with it then?
Yeah,
what's going on?
Because I had to check this nigga. I'm like, hold on.
Are we together or are we not? Well, let me know something.
But Ace, like, I would say this. Like, when we first got together, it was like we kind of like got... We went really fast.
Yeah.
Like, the second week, we found love in a hopeless place. We was already saying we love each other. Like, I just remember you asking me, like, I don't remember you saying, like, are we together or you be my girlfriend?
Look at
like
Mo
that.
Shaking his head. It's some
you
bullshit.
Said, what did you say?
It's
you
some
said,
damn bullshit. They full of shit.
This is the honest to God truth. Like, I swear. You said, you was like, is you my girl? Or some you said, and I was just like, duh, like, yeah. And it was, that's literally how we got together.
Yeah.
I never feel like we actually had, like, the talking stage, I guess. Like,
yeah, I feel like we kind of got close really fast.
Real fast, yeah.
You know, we ain't had nothing but time. We ain't had nothing going on.
Yeah, we used to be outside. You know what I'm saying? When I say we was outside every day, like, then, yeah, he took me to STL Finest.
Oh man, them sticky wings, man. Clap it up for them sticky wings. Damn, I missed that chicken, man.
We I used to meet up with him at this club called 609. Like we used to just do a lot of stuff. Man. Like we kicked it. That's what I would say. Like we literally like we got together in a time where like St. Louis was lit. Like we was outside. Boy, so we had a really good time. I enjoyed those stages. So if you're dating somebody, like you went from talking, now y'all are like dating. I don't know if it's exclusive or not. I guess it's just like a conversation that you should have. Do you feel like, can you still talk to other people if you're dating? Like y'all going on, this is like y'all fourth or fifth date at this point.
You know what? It just depends on the person and where they're at in their dating life, in their romantic life. I mean, that's just really all it comes down to. Like, I mean, some people might consider, you know, the talking stage is, you know, talking to somebody and focusing on that one person, you know. Other people might feel like, okay, yeah, I'm dating, but I mean, you know, I ain't got no ring on my finger yet.
By other people, you mean men.
Hey, mind your business, man.
No, that's what you mean.
Y'all
like to string people along, and I don't like that. Like, I feel like, no, you mean nothing. I feel like y'all want us to do everything a girlfriend does. Drink, y'all want us to go out with y'all. Y'all want us to, you know, spend a night with y'all almost every night, unless y'all got another little sneaky link y'all trying to have over. Y'all want us to cook. Y'all want us to clean. Like, y'all want us to be there for y'all. But it's like, but y'all don't want to put that title on it, or y'all don't want to, like, you know, let other people know that we with y'all. Like, y'all want us to be a secret and all this shit.
But I feel like that's not the case with everybody. Some people, you know, some people are on that type of time. Other people are more willing to, you know.
And then, you know what? I can't even lie, though. It do depend on your age, too, though. Like, it depends on how old you are.
It depends on your experience. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, as an adult.
Now,
as
if you
person,
our age and you and all of the shit that we saying, you still going through this, like, damn. That's all I'm say. I mean, like, when you talking to people, like, if you don't... I feel like at this age, like, I'm very, like, I could communicate and talk about anything. So I feel like now, if I was still dating or whatever, like, I would just say what I want. Like, it wouldn't even be confusion because I would literally just, like, communicate everything.
So I see what you're saying. And
back
again,
then,
you know?
You'd be kind of timid. You don't really know, like, what you kind of want in your life, or you don't know if you want to be in a relationship or not. So you just kind of go with the flow.
Right.
But, yeah, I feel like that's a conversation that you got to have to kind of see, like, where y'all are. Because everybody is different. Not everybody is looking to be in a relationship or settle down or whatever. Some people just like talking to multiple people, and there's nothing wrong with that.
But... okay, so what if the person is upfront with the person? Mm-hmm. Like, what if they're like, hey, you know, we just kicking it right now. I ain't really on that type of time.
Okay, that's fine. But that ain't nothing wrong with that. That's up to me. Mm-hmm. But I like the fact that if you do say that, you're giving me a choice.
Right.
So it's my choice if I continue to still talk to you or date you when I know that there's a possibility that I may not get nothing out of this. So at least you're giving me a choice. But most men not going to do that. That's the problem. A lot of, like, most men are not going to be that upfront about, like, what their intentions are, because most of them just trying to fuck. So it's like, what do you do at that point? That's true, like, right? That's true.
And
that's hella true. I don't care what you say. Like,
it just depends on the person, man. It just depends on the person. That ain't the truth, everybody. Y'all want to make every man a dog so bad.
No, I'm not saying, babe, you're not a dog. But you had dog ways, but you're not a dog.
Hey, that's my past life, man. I'm a changed man.
I'm just saying, like,
look at the range, man.
Yeah.
I got a whole new game plan.
Mm-hmm, you sure do.
Man.
No, I'm just saying, like, I just wish that, like, when I talk to my friends about, like, them dating people and stuff like that, I just wish men would be more upfront and honest about, like, what their intentions are.
Yeah, that I feel like That's with anybody. You know what I'm saying? Women or men, you know. Yeah.
Who, at this age.
Either party. Yeah, either party. At this age.
As you get older, yeah. For sure.
And I know everybody not about to rush into marriage, you know, today or tomorrow.
And marriage is.
And, you know, we don't, you know, push that on nobody. You know what I'm saying? Take your time, you know, figure out what you need to figure out. You know, make sure y'all on the same page, all that good stuff, you know.
Yeah.
It's great. You know what I mean? It's lit. Mm-hmm. Don't get me wrong. But at the same time, a lot of people aren't, you know, marriage material.
Yeah.
Or they're not willing. Well, I guess that's why they're not marriage material.
They're not willing
material,
to make
they're not willing
sacrifice.
To compromise and make sacrifices and, you know.
Flat out.
Yeah.
So, that's the dating stage.
Mm-hmm.
we just kind of summed that up. Okay, so like dating, then I feel like the last stage of like commitment, of course, would be marriage, but like we're not gonna really talk about that because we know what comes with marriage. But it, I would say like just making sure, like, or just trying to figure out if y'all are exclusive. Like, how do you know, like, what happens or what should you expect when you are exclusive? Like, if you're exclusive, do you still, are you still able to date other people? Like, it's like, how do you know if you're exclusive, or how do you?
I feel like being exclusive means, okay, I'm your man, you're my girl.
I'm gonna tell it to the whole world.
You know what I'm saying? I feel like if we're exclusive, then it's just me and you.
Definitely.
You know, we're building something and we're
trying
to.
Y'all stand with each other damn near every night.
You know
night.
What I'm saying? If we're exclusive, then that means we're an item.
Yes.
To me, in my mind, that's how I perceive it. Yes. Like, we're together.
And that's when things get complicated, too. Like, you start arguing. That first argument ain't no bitch. Mm-hmm. Like,
So what is we then? what we doing?
Are we here or not? Are we going to continue this or not?
So what? We together?
Is it worth it? Yeah.
Damn.
That's how you know you low-key exclusive.
Let me know something.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And then, also, I feel like you exclusive when you start meeting each other, families and stuff. Because that's a big piece. Because you kind of got to see, like, what you are getting yourself
right,
into.
Right. That's true. That's
families
true.
Families is families. Like,
that's a big deal.
That's a huge deal.
For us, man, for men, that's a big deal, man. You meet Mom Dukes.
Yeah.
You a real one.
Definitely.
Because everybody just ain't meeting Mom Dukes. Everybody ain't getting them cheesy potatoes. You know,
man,
what I'm talking
them,
about?
Hey, everybody I killed them cheesy potatoes.
Clapping up them cheesy potatoes, man.
I was fucking
Kitty ain't whipping up them potatoes for just anybody.
Man,
so
flat out.
Know
hey,
that.
Yo, hey, Ace Perns, what I will say, when we was like getting together and stuff, like when I say they cook every day, when I say every day, I mean every day. Like, I had a meal every single day. And that was lit as fuck. Like, just, I was like, damn, your parents cook every day.
They love to cook, man.
That shit was lit. So at this time, we do have a special guest on our show.
Yep, yep.
Y'all may know her. Y'all may not know her. Her name is Vi, and she is specializing in credit. She's also
credit wizard.
Definitely a credit wizard, and she's also a nurse, and she's also an entrepreneur. So, Vi, you're welcome to come over. She's going to come clap it up for Vi.
Come on, Vi.
And she's going to give y'all some gems on credit.
She's going to give y'all a lot of free game.
Yeah, free game.
You know, not too much, not too much. Just enough to get you rolling, you know what I'm saying?
Ahead.
Because y'all got to make sure, you know,
get
y'all sign
together,
up
babe.
For her services and stuff, you
so,
know.
Yeah. So, give us a second. She's going to get her stuff hooked up.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, you get some straight now. Yeah, get on in there.
Scoot out with me.
Yo, me and Vi go way back. For those of y'all
who
don't know, we go way back. Mm-hmm. What was it, middle school?
Way back.
Middle school, man.
I'm
even back then,
so
y'all.
Scoot over so she can.
You said what?
Scoot
my
over
bad.
So she can scoot over. Okay. So, yeah, Vi, I just want you to, I've already kind of introduced you, but you can introduce yourself and just kind of tell us what you do. And, yeah. On the mic.
Yeah, it's on.
Okay, so sorry about that, y'all. But yeah, so welcome by to Young Murder Lynn. Thank you for coming. We love you.
Vi got
them gems though. That's what I'm gonna say. Like, that's why I wanted to bring her on the show, because I feel like
for sure
having good credit and like just being a boss ass bitch is something that I feel like the universe needs to know about.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want her to kind of tell us about herself and what she does and all of that good stuff. Hey, this free game though, so make sure y'all pay attention.
No doubt.
So there you go, bye.
First off, I want to give it back to y'all. Y'all are the real bosses of the city.
Thank you. Turn up for the bosses. Hey, I like that. I appreciate that. Right on, sis. I appreciate that.
Thank you.
Real recognize real.
Man, if y'all have not been to His and Hers, you don't know what you're missing out on.
You know, people be just kind of sleeping, but it's all good, though. They going to wake up one day.
Man, this store is amazing.
Thank you. This store is beautiful.
Like,
thank you so much.
This store is about to be in multiple different states. Mm. So if you're missing out on this clothing and business entrepreneurs who are humble, who want to make you look good and make you look different, they don't want you to look like everybody else.
That's what I be saying, bye.
I'm trying to tell you.
You missing out.
Hey. Flat out.
Come through.
But anyway, my name is Vi Broadinax. We go way back. I am a nurse. I've been in the medical field for about 10 years now. And I was working a lot of hours as a nurse. I'm 60, 70 hours a week. Stressed out, depressed. I loved what I did. I loved helping people, but I was looking for another way to help people, help people in their life. And this opportunity came about with helping people fix their credit. And it really has changed my life. So I help people fix their credit, and then I help them get their health together. So that's kind of...
So how did you get started? Like, what was like... What was the breaking point for you to make you be like, hey, enough of this world. Let me focus on something else.
You want to know the real reason? One day I was sitting at home. I had gained so much weight because when I was working as a nurse, like I said, I was working 60, 70 hours a week. I mean, money going out like crazy. I don't even know where my money went. I'm still looking for it. I mean, I couldn't even tell you what a budget is back then. And so, I mean, just stressed out, and I needed to find something different to do. Like, that was not fulfilling me anymore. And if you're not happy, I was gaining weight. I was overweight. Like, going up and down the steps. Couldn't breathe, shortness of breath. Like, it was at a point where my health was suffering from the career that I had.
It's crazy.
Isn't that crazy how your career was to help people? Your health, your own health was deteriorating. You know, that's crazy.
People expect nurses to be superheroes, but at the end of the day, we be suffering to help other people out.
Yeah, like, I could feel that.
And so one day... on Facebook, somebody had made like a status or something. I comment on the status, and the guy inboxed me, and I told him I was trying to work on people's credit like for free. He was like, "Why are you doing that?"
Yeah, why you was doing that, Vi?
He said, "Why are you doing that?" I was like, "Well, I don't know. I mean, I'm just Googling stuff trying to figure out how to fix somebody's credit. I don't know what I'm doing." And so he was like, "Well, I have an opportunity where you can, if you have negative and derogatory items on your credit report, we can dispute those items, and you have a way to make additional income if you want part-time income." And at this time, I'm working 60, 70 hours a week. And this opportunity... I only needed to pay $300. I was looking for the $300 from the 60, 70 hours a week to maybe I need to do this because, you know, he was, I mean, everything sounded good with this opportunity, but I'm like, oh, I don't know. This is kind of, I ain't never did that before. But when I say 3 years in, I've been doing it, my life has definitely changed.
No, clap it up for that. Sure. And we see it too. We definitely see it. We see you helping other people.
Some people just talk about it, but I definitely can see that you about it. And absolutely. We appreciate that. Absolutely. You ain't capped, Vi. We appreciate you not being
capped. I might have been when I was working 67 hours a week and I thought I was getting a bag, but I was draining the bag.
Right, for sure.
I feel that. Hey, for sure. I understand. If anybody understand, I understand.
Right.
Flat out.
Absolutely.
Okay, so what would you say, like, what is the most important thing about getting your credit together? Like, what can you do with good credit?
Man, you can do so much. That 3-digit number.
Yeah.
Mm. When I say it has changed my life, and I'm not faking, it has changed my life. Like, it took some time to get it together. Mm-hmm. But I went from a 650 to an 803. Wow. So now I'm at over
clap it up.
Whoa. Hey.
So you have excellent credit.
I have
Hold on, y'all. You went to a what, Vi?
I went from a 650.
Okay, I heard that part. I heard that part.
603.
Wow.
My brain can't even process it. Like, that is crazy. That is insane.
I promise I did not know that was possible.
Wow.
That's crazy, man. That's amazing. Sure, man, for sure.
Yeah, that's amazing. For sure.
Yep. And so I think you can do a lot of stuff with good credit. Mm-hmm. Do you know that most people in their lifetime will pay over $1 million in interest with bad credit, with less than perfect credit? Wow. Over $1 million. You know what you can buy with $1 million?
Mm-hmm. Right, for sure.
Yeah.
But you paying out that with bad credit. Mm-hmm. I mean, you go to these car lots. I mean, you can come in here with bad credit, no credit. And
they're going to charge you interest up there.
It's so much interest that they're charging you. You can go and get a car if you need a car because you're doing what you have to do. But you need to come and see me first.
Flat out.
For sure.
Or in the process. Mm-hmm. Because it's not cool paying $50,000 for a $10,000 car.
Yes. Oh, definitely. God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
I've done that before.
Me too.
Shit.
You just don't know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My first car, I paid 29% interest on my first car.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That wasn't even worth $2,000.
Right.
Mm.
And I know I paid close to $20,000 for that car.
Yeah, I feel you on that. Yeah. RIP to the Charger, man.
And I had a Grand Am GT that broke down on me.
But you were sliding though.
Right.
I'll show you.
So, Vi, what's the name of your companies?
So, the name of the company is United Wealth Education. We're working on building wealth for people. We don't just want to fix your credit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we want to build wealth in the communities. Like, we're not looking, a lot of people, they get credit, they'll get their credit fixed, and then they'll go mess it up again because they don't understand you can't pay late on stuff. You have to use a certain utilization on your credit cards. Now, some people will say, why did my credit score drop?
Mm-hmm.
One of the number one things is we weren't taught financial literacy in school. So,
and they should bring, like, that's one thing I don't understand. Like, why is that not being taught in school?
It is in certain schools.
Mm.
It is.
Mm. Wow.
Yep. It's just, so our company was going around prior to the pandemic and they were teaching children from 8 to 18 the matters of personal finance.
Wow. Yep. Yeah. They need, especially our youth, because I feel like this generation, like, they want businesses. They want, like, way more than what we were thinking about at that age.
Right.
So having good credit is, like, detrimental to your future for sure. Like, you really can't do anything with, you can do it, but you just gonna pay hella interest,
right?
Or you gonna continue to be denied.
The deal, whatever deal you get, it won't be in your favor.
That would you know what the breaking point for me was, because I had bad credit for a very long time until I decided, like, you know what, F this, like, I need to get my shit together.
Right.
What broke me?
F this, I need to get my shit together. I'm sorry.
Don't do that.
I'm sorry.
What broke me was, like, I think I wanted to, I was at a dealership or something, and I wanted to get, I don't remember what kind of car it was. I think I may have wanted a Charger or something, and they denied me, and I was there for almost 8 hours.
Mm.
Yes, and I still got denied.
That's a whole work day.
Yes.
That's crazy.
And I was like, nah, this ain't the move.
Wow.
And just not being able to, like, buy what I want to buy, and, you know, stuff like that, like applying for credit cards and being denied. Like, I just feel like that's not my life. Like, that's not the type of lifestyle or, like, any... Like, I didn't want that for myself. So, you literally, like, it takes a long time for you to get your credit back together. And I feel like a lot of us just didn't know. Because nobody taught me about credit. Mm-hmm. Like, I would always hear, like, my dad talk about, like, having good credit. But, like, nobody showed me how to have credit, you know?
And that's the thing. They'll tell you, do this, do that, save money when you're growing up.
Save,
but they won't tell you how to save. Nope. I need
or why.
Or why to save. Yep. Exactly. What am I saving for? Because I'm 19 years old. What am I saving for? I want
to learn. Right, yep. and that's what I did by when I turned 18. Mm-hmm. You know, back then, when you turn 18, they used to send you the credit card.
Me?
You didn't even have to apply.
I maxed out that whole
thing. Man, I
Shout out to K. Hey, Jewelers.
K Jewelers.
Hey, got that class ring, like, got that gold chain. You know what I'm saying? Got me right.
Man. When I turned 18, I had like 4 credit cards. I had one. I remember one was like $1,000. I'm my God, right. Rich.
Yep.
Like $1,000.
Yep. I had
one for $1,000, one for like $400, $1,200. You know, little like, and that's good, but it wasn't like. At that age, I was like, oh, this is a lot of money.
Right.
It was.
So I just maxed them off. I didn't even know.
Maxed them out.
Completely. I didn't even understand. This is how illiterate I was when it came to credit. I thought you didn't have to pay it back. I just thought. I thought they was just giving you, you know. I was like, free money.
Wow. So,
that's what you thought.
I learned. And I didn't even. And again, I'm 18. So once me and Ace got together, we started trying to like do stuff. And I was like, why are we getting denied? Like,
that was the worst.
He didn't have credit established.
Right.
Mm-hmm. My problem was my credit was fucked up. So it was like, okay, what we finna do? Because we ain't gonna be able to do shit. Right. Like, one of us gotta do something.
Young people, if you are with somebody that you really love and you really care about, build your credit up, man, before you sign on that dotted line, before y'all become one, man. Make sure you try to work on it at least a little bit, man, because you don't both want to be in the same boat, you know.
And that's really what it was. Like, when we start talking about marriage and stuff like that, like, we knew that we wanted to. We actually moved out of town for 2 years. So once we were out of town, like, when we first moved, we was bad credit, like, just nothing
established. And that was the eye-opener, you know, like, you know, people say that stuff all the time about, like, you know, I need to move away or whatever like that. Thinking that that's going to solve all their problems, but...
Problems follow you.
You know what I'm saying? So we moved out of town and we tried to do different things, apply for places and get different cars and stuff. And it was all bad, man, you know?
It was crazy.
Denied. I'm like,
so
why we keep
many
getting,
denials.
You know,
and
why
I'm
we
like,
keep getting denied? You know, we got decent jobs.
Right,
you know?
And that's why I'm like, I got money. Like, what you mean? Like,
forget that number. Fuck that number. What about this money that you see?
Right.
You know,
like, what?
They weren't trying to hear that, you know? They weren't trying to hear that shit.
And I was like, you know what, babe? Like, once we start, because we start talking about marriage when we were still out of town. So once we start to talk about marriage, I was like, okay, if we're going to get married, like, we need to get our shit together. So what are we going to do? And it always came. I'm like, let me look into this credit thing. Because, again, I had no idea. Like, I didn't, I don't know. It just didn't click in my mind. Like, okay, you got to have good credit. Because, again, all my parents are saying, save your money. Like, nothing about, like, credit. Like, no, nothing. All I remember is don't get no credit cards. But I already had four or five of them already. Like, this five, I'm shit, 3-4 years? Like, girl, too late. Listen,
it's too late for that.
Speaking of credit cards, Vi, what is the usage percentage that you recommend?
Mm-hmm. We always argue about this, Vi.
Yeah. Ooh, I'm going to start.
I'm trying to figure this out, I'm trying to understand some things.
So in general, the internet will tell you under 30%, but we tell people somewhere under 20%, and it will be excellent to be under 10%.
Bye.
Okay.
Say that again, Vi.
Okay.
In general, Google.
I heard you the first time.
This man.
I heard you the first time.
Bye. He feel like 30%. Oh, I'm good. I'm like, no. You need to go a little lower.
I got it now.
Like, I'll be trying to tell him, like, listen, like, I'm going to stay at 9-10%.
Yep.
Sir, do what you want to do. But yep. I'm staying, like, right here now. If I want to splurge and do something, yeah, I'm going to do it. But for the most part, I try to make sure that I'm within that 9-12%, you know, that's what I like to see.
And that's the benefits of good credit, because you really don't have to, unless you're buying stuff that's really, really expensive, mm-hmm. you get higher limit credit cards
yep.
when you have a better credit score. Mm-hmm. Lower interest rate, higher limit credit cards. So you ain't got to worry about going over the 30% yep. with a $5,000 credit card.
Exactly.
$10,000. You got $20,000 that you can, you know, mm-hmm. kind of play with.
And exactly.
That 10% utilization, like, you have that to play with. And so, credit can change your life.
That's yeah. That's what we're going to say. Flat out.
Clap it up a good credit.
Clap it up. I got to clap credit. For real. Because we've been through the struggle.
Man, like.
For sure.
I always try to say, like, you know, like, anything can happen. Like, literally anything in your life can happen. You could be on top now and be at the bottom tomorrow. So it's like, I feel like having, like, financial stability, including credit, stuff like that, like, it's literally the most important thing.
For
especially
sure.
like trying to be an entrepreneur, like, everything costs money.
Yeah.
So it was just like, we can't do none of this right. without having decent credit, at least. Like,
thanks.
Let's try to aim for, like, excellence. So that's what I'm trying to do now. I'm trying to get to the excellent. Like, mm-hmm. I'm right before. Mm-hmm. So I need to know, how can I get over this hump? Because mm-hmm. I told you about that last time you mm-hmm. was here. Like, I need to get to that excellent status. So
right.
I'm working, though. I would say I'm proud of myself on how far I've come. And I'm proud of Ace, too, because little baby ain't had nothing. He ain't had no credit.
No credit, right.
When we first got together. But right. he good. Hey, Big Daddy gonna buy some shit.
I was like, bitch with no ass. I ain't had shit.
But, babe, we ain't had shit together.
Clap
so
it up for progression.
Cool, like, yeah, clap it up for progression.
It's bad.
So, Vi, this is a part of the show where we start to ask you questions.
Okay.
So, you got something to drink? Because you might have
it's
to take
I left
little...
it over there.
Okay.
It's the cup on the table. It's a little cup. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We're going to have a little interlude to Mo get back with that cup.
Taurus.
Thank you, sir. There you go, bud. Thank you.
Run that back, Turbo.
How the hell you love that bitch? You don't know that bitch. It's like having set prices on a diamond brick. You get good pussy once and then start cuffing it. I slip it in my bag, I'm just on other shit.
That's my jam.
We're gonna get flagged.
Let me chill.
Okay, so you are really our first. Well, we had my friend Shiny on for the first, but it was kind of random.
Shiny Bomb.
Shout out to Shiny Bomb. But you are our official, like, first guest of Young Married and Lit. So
okay. Oh, that
you special.
You are special.
I feel special.
We had guests when we were just doing, like, on Apple Podcasts, Anchor mm-hmm. and stuff like that, but we have not had any visual guests like that.
Mm-hmm.
So this game is called Drink or Think.
Okay.
So basically, I'm gonna ask you a few questions. If you don't want to answer it, you just have to drink. Okay.
Okay.
And that could be a shot, that could be, you know, you drinking out of your cup or whatever you
okay.
want to do.
Okay.
And we just going to start with the first question.
Cool.
First question is, what is your relationship status? She drinking, y'all.
Oh, man.
How you going to start off drinking?
Shit.
God damn.
She ain't getting off to a good start, is she? Why?
Somebody ain't off to a good start.
Somebody must be watching. Somebody must be watching.
I'm not off to a good start.
Hey. So, hey, they, I don't know what her, if y'all trying to
it's
get
all
her,
good,
y'all
going
to get her
hey.
DMs. No, stay on my DMs.
Oh, man.
This good credit got me running multiple businesses.
Hey, flat out, she a busy lady. So you gotta be.
What's your honor?
You still, hey, so you drinking today, right? Now, I didn't mention this, but you only get to do that 3 times. Oh. And it's 10 questions.
Okay, that's fine.
Oh, okay.
Man. I got it.
So, I just made that up out of it.
She gonna tell you.
Flat out. I'm an honest person. Okay, question number 2. What's your type?
You know what? As I get older, I don't really have a type. I need somebody that's going to treat me right. I need a leader, somebody who presents leadership. They don't necessarily have to be an entrepreneur, but if they are, that's a plus because that's my lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Someone that's loyal. Mm. I don't want nobody that's disloyal that you talk to this person, that person, that person, that can't
that's
juggle.
The main thing.
For like, sure.
You know what I'm saying? And a good communicator.
Gotcha. That's great.
Mm-hmm.
Those are great things.
Absolutely.
Flat out. Okay. Question number 3. What's your favorite position?
Ooh.
Oh my God. I'm gonna drink to that.
Oh man. Oh shit.
My favorite. No, you know what? I ain't gonna drink to that.
Shit. Oh,
my favorite position.
Bring it back.
Bring it back.
Y'all want to know for real? What is? Y'all ain't ready.
I already know what you're going to say.
Y'all ain't ready. My favorite position is CEO.
Hey. Hey.
Now, let me tell you
I done broke the clap button.
Let me tell you something.
I ain't drinking to that one.
Turn up. Low key,
I would have said the same shit.
Okay.
Like, some stuff is just supposed to be your own.
That's
you
dope.
Know what I'm saying?
That's dope.
So, but I might be drunk enough and say something, but I'm just saying, if I am how I am now, like, I'm going to say CEO. That's
for
what
sure.
My favorite position is.
Yep.
Okay, so number 4 is fuck, marry, kill. Let me think of 3 people.
Fuck, marry, kill?
Mm-hmm.
Who do I want to marry?
Well, I'm going to give you 3 names, and it has to be, you have to tell me who you'll fuck, who you'll marry, and who you'll kill.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay, so I'm going to say, babe, you come up with 3 names.
Man, I ain't coming up with no men, with no men's. You figure that out. It's your question.
Okay, I'm going to say,
She going to name all light-skinned niggas, because she like them red.
Shut up, what? I like you. Okay, I'm going to just say Nelly. Nelly, Smino. We're gonna do St. Louis people. Nelly, Smino, and Chingy.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Fuck, marry, kill.
Okay. Well, I don't know who Smino is.
Okay.
I'm sorry. So I don't know who I'm gonna marry. My friend wanna marry Nelly, so I can't marry him. So I marry Chingy.
Okay. Chingaling.
Chingaling.
Shout out my boy Chingaling.
Flat out. Clap it up for Chingaling.
So love. Ooh. You know what I'm saying?
I might have to have like a one night stand or something with the Smino thing person. I don't know.
Okay. So F him.
And
kill Nelly.
Oh, I don't want to kill Nelly.
Don't kill Nelly.
I can't kill Nelly. We got to have another one because I can't kill Nelly. Nelly, that's my boy.
Yeah. I'm hollering. Okay, next question. This is hella funny. What's the initial of your sneaky link? Like, what's their name initials?
I don't have one.
Damn.
I know. Because I ain't sneaking, doing nothing. So I don't have one.
So what you're saying is you're linking, but you ain't sneaking.
There we go.
Okay. I just had to clarify
okay.
that. Okay.
Don't be putting me out there. I'm just connecting the dots.
You know what I'm saying?
He definitely connecting the dots. Okay, next question. Who is your celebrity crush?
Ooh, Lorenz Tate.
Okay. So you be watching Power and stuff?
I used to, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Cool.
Yep.
Next question. When is the last time you had sex? Why are you laughing?
She wild.
Did she drink?
She wild.
Hey, somebody watching her ass on her. That's all I gotta say.
Don't be watching me.
Next question. This is a good one. Next question. What's the best thing about yourself?
Aw. Ooh, okay. See, when you gotta describe yourself, you be like, hold on. Mm-hmm. I think a really good thing about me is that I am a very determined person.
That's great.
No doubt.
I'm determined to do something, like I go after it and it's just like overkill. Mm-hmm. Now you ask me who I want to kill. I'm overkilling whatever goal that I have to get to. So
that's great. Mm-hmm. That's a great answer. I like that about
you
too.
Dope.
Okay. You getting through these questions.
Yes. Making them through.
Number 9. What's something we don't know about you?
Something you do not know about me.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. I'm a procrastinator.
Never.
Wow.
What? I don't believe that vibe.
Yeah, I went to middle school with this woman.
She always said how smart she
every assignment mm-hmm. on time.
Everything. Yes.
Every piece of homework. Yep. Everything.
Yep.
Hey, you still friends with that girl that y'all used to eat the ramen noodles with?
Yep.
I'm hollering. With
hey, you see the ramen noodles in the class with
really?
The pack? Oh my God.
I'm still friends.
That's crazy. That's what's
good,
up.
Though.
Tell I said what's up, man. She was cool too, man. She was cool too.
Okay. Yeah, that was a good answer.
The ramen noodle chips.
I'm last talking. So you did drink on 3 questions. So
no, that was only 2. I didn't actually drink on the question.
Oh, because you said your same position.
Oh, so she took it like a G then, is what you're saying.
Uh-huh.
So she did a good job.
Yeah,
okay.
We got one more question.
Sure.
Yeah,
one more question.
Number 10.
To that one.
So with this, we always going to ask our guests this because we just want to know, what's one thing you love about Young Married and Lit podcast?
I think the one thing that I love about Young Married and Lit is because you all set the example for especially brown people. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You can be young and you can be married and you can have a good time. Like people think that when you get married, your life is over.
Mm-hmm.
They think that, oh, we getting married. Oh, she can't do this without him. And they can't. Like, you still 2 individual people who just
definitely
came together, had goals, or maybe you set goals together.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? And so the Young Married and Lit, like, I feel like it's reaching out to a lot of people our age and it's making people think differently about relationships, marriage.
And that's literally like the main reason why we started this.
Mm-hmm.
Like Young Married and Lit is literally Young Married and Lit. Like and it's like now that we're getting older, like you got to think we started Young Married and Lit like 4 or 5 years ago. We came up with the name. So at this point we was like 25, 26.
Mm-hmm.
So we're 32 at this point. So we still young, we still married and lit, but
you know what I'm saying? Hey, don't get it confused.
Don't get
it twisted, you know what I'm saying?
But I just feel like we have matured so much. So
definitely.
We still lit, but I know how to control my lit. Like I don't go out every weekend like I used to. I don't first of all, I ain't got the energy. That's the first thing.
Okay.
I love my bed. I love to be in the bed.
Me too.
So, you know, I ain't lit like that no more. I jam, but I don't I'm not the person that has to go out all the time no more.
Right.
I feel like we've done that. Like I feel like we've literally like went out for like 6-7 days
centuries
a week. Like
right.
You know what I'm saying? Like so long. When I be looking at y'all ever be looking at y'all memories on like Snapchat and Facebook and be like, damn.
Like
we was outside.
I'm yawning now.
We was outside. So that's literally what Young Married and Lit is about. And we appreciate it. I like that that's what you like about Young Married and Lit.
Right on. We appreciate
that's
it.
That's lit.
For sure.
So, Vi, you welcome to stay on the show. Or if you got to go, we understand. But what we normally do now is we do have questions from our viewers. So I'm not going to answer all these questions. We're going to save some for the next show.
Okay.
But I do want to go over a couple because y'all had a lot of questions this week, so babe, clap it up for the questions, because I appreciate when y'all interact with us.
Okay. Yeah, it's a bunch of
okay, so first question is, somebody asks us, what is the best thing about our relationship?
If I had to say, I'd say the jam. We be jamming. We have a good time with each other.
Yeah, I would probably say the same thing. Like, and it comes down to like us being friends. Like, that's what I would say. Like,
yeah.
I like the fact that I feel like I got a man. I got a man. I got a friend. I got a fuck buddy. Like, I got like everybody.
Clap it up.
I got like the ultimate. That. I feel like I got like the ultimate person. Like, we go through a lot with each other. Good. We went through a lot with each other. So it's like, we don't have no secrets. Like, we just know each other. So it's like, that's what I enjoy most about us. Next question. How often do you think married people or people in relationships should be intimate or have sex?
Oh, man.
Every day, boo. No, I'm just playing. Hey.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
If you got the energy, right. Because I ain't going to lie to you.
Yeah.
Every day, maybe when you're 21. But it's very important, I will say that. So it just kind of depends on you and your partner. I don't feel like y'all should be going weeks without that, but it depends on you and your partner. Like, a lot of people are busy, like got kids and families and stuff like that. So sex should not be the most important thing in your relationship. It's up there.
If you got all that time to lay on your back, you probably broke.
Yeah, you more than likely you hey, that's a bar.
Hey, come on now.
That's a fact.
You laying on your back.
That's a fact. So it's like I said, it's very important, but it ain't every day. Maybe if we on vacation or something. Niggas be tired. But see, that's the thing though. You may not like, and that's what I enjoy about me and Ace relationship is like, even if it's not like a sex thing every single day, like I could say we're intimate every day. Mm-hmm. Like, whether that's cuddling, rubbing, or, you know, whatever, like, we always have some type
of. I love a good rub.
Oh, yeah. Ace love a good rub. He love. Rub y'all nigga feet, like, flat out. If y'all got a good nigga.
Clap it up for that, man. Hey.
He love a good foot rub, you know y'all.
I ain't got ugly feet either.
And he got nice. Hey, he got nice, you know, feet. And I like the fact that
I wouldn't even do it like that if I had them dogs barking.
Yeah. I still rub them though, cause you got to work and work hard for us. So I'm gonna rub them dogs.
I appreciate that.
But I feel like we are just, I don't know, like we just mesh well. That's what I'm gonna say. Number three. I'm dead. Number three is, why white people don't be having cousins? That shit true though. I mean,
yo.
Who asked that?
Yo.
Oh, I ain't gonna God.
White people, come on the show.
Mo, hook that up for us.
We need this question answered.
Oh no, like, but listen.
Expeditiously.
Listen. I had to put my real glass down. But I would say
that's
this.
That's a
like,
good question. I'm too drunk for this.
I had a best friend that's white. So I would always hear her talk about her cousins. Mm-hmm. So I
but
know,
did you see them?
Now that's no.
See? Okay. Yeah, we got to get to the bottom of this.
Yeah. White where people, y'all where cousins y'all cousins at?
Where but is y'all
you
cousins?
Know what? You know what somebody told me?
What?
That white people be dating their cousins, so it don't really be their cousins.
It
be their husband and wife. That's what I heard. Hey, I'm just the messenger. I don't know how true it is, but I'm just the messenger.
AFMHR.
Oh, God. He's HR. Oh, I'm dead. But yeah, that's what the viewers asked, so I'm answering.
Wow.
Number four. A lot of people ask me this question. Who pays the bills if the woman makes more money than her man?
Ooh.
I'm going to let you answer that.
Mm.
Hey, man. As a man, you take care of your business and you do what you can do. You know, you make the best of what you have. You know what I'm saying? You just make sure that you're contributing and you're looking out for your household and you're taking care of your business on your end, whatever that may be, whatever you can do. You know what I'm saying? If she make more money than you, it's cool, you know? I mean, she got a couple more dollars to, you know, buy a couple more slices of cheese, you know, for the burger. You know what I'm saying? That's cool, you know, but...
When I was making more money with Ace, y'all, first of all, he full of shit. When I was making more money with Ace, he was clapping and raving. Babe, you going to work? Why you ain't going to work today? Like, I'm like, nigga, like...
Clap it up for that. Clap it up for that.
Like, chill.
Clap it up for that.
He wanted me to go to work.
Hey, I'm just saying, man. Them checks was looking pretty good. Hey, I was, you know.
I had to
get some understanding.
Ain't no shame in my game. Cause I was making them bags.
You know what I'm saying?
But I would say, like, and then another question that was, they were saying, like, and what did somebody ask me? It was like something to do with funds. It was like, how do you go about being married and like how do you handle your funds? Like, do you automatically have like a joint account, or like do you have your own account? And my advice is like, we have a joint account and then mm-hmm. we have our own accounts. Mm-hmm. So I would just say like all of the bills goes to the joint account. But mm-hmm. we don't control each other's money. Like he pays, like I said, the bills are together. Mm-hmm. But he do what he want to do with his money, and I do what I want to do with my money, and we still come together. It's not like a his money, my money thing, because
facts.
It's still really the same. Facts. But at the same time, like, it is good to have your own money too, because this shit you want to do yourself. So I would just say have a joint one and then have your own too. That's
good,
my
advice. Good advice.
Wow. Okay, this is like a question, but it's a okay. What advice would you give someone who's going through a hard time? Like, my boyfriend cheated on me and had a baby. I love him and I want to be with him. I even believe he loves me and he proposed, but I don't know if I can forgive him. Let me break this down. So you saying that you got a boyfriend, he cheated on you, got a girl pregnant, you found out, and then he proposed to you. And y'all want to be together. So you trying to figure out if you want to be with him or not? Is that what y'all got from that?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Ooh, child.
Mm-hmm. This is what I'm going to say about that. I feel like, me personally, where the knife at? Like, where the...
Damn.
Where the gun? Like, where my gat at? Like,
okay.
You know?
Okay.
Something.
Okay.
Because this is the thing, though. Like, I feel like everybody makes mistakes. Specifically, men.
Man, hey, you gotta chill. You gotta relax, woman.
I'm not saying, like, I'm just saying, like, in that instance, is what I'm saying. This is a very hard question for me.
That's wild. That's a wild boy.
I would just say this. Like, go. Me personally, like, y'all not married, so I can't really. My mind is not going to be the same because y'all not married. But if it's your boyfriend, he had a baby on you, I would say leave him, because you never, ever going to trust him. And I feel like it don't matter if he never does anything ever again. Mm-hmm. You still not going to trust him. Mm-hmm. And how are you going to deal with the new baby? Like, are you going to accept the child? Because you can't treat people, children, different. Right. The baby didn't have nothing to do with that. So you have to really be mentally ready for that type of stuff.
Yeah, I stop punishing these babies, man.
Yeah, yep. Definitely.
For sure.
So I would just say my advice is, don't ask me no shit like that, because I'm just, you know, like, I wish a nigga would have a baby on me. I feel like that's very disrespectful.
Ooh, very.
But again, like, nobody is perfect. So, you know, I'm not going to judge anybody's situation. I just feel
We don't yuck nobody over here. Hey, if you, at YML, you know what I'm saying?
If you can find it in your heart to forgive him and y'all move on and have a beautiful relationship, so be it. But me, for me, nah, it wouldn't be no forgiving for that. So that's how I would answer. But from a male's perspective, like, what would you do? Like, how would, like, what?
If my girl got pregnant.
By another man.
By another nigga.
What you doing, babe?
Oh man.
Babe, you know what your ass gonna do. He gonna knock you by the side of your head and be like, nah, I'm good. He never gonna trust you again.
He
ain't gonna fuck with you.
I don't think he's coming back from that.
Yeah. It's like, but I feel like, again, like, people, a lot of people's relationship is different, like were y'all broken up during the time?
Right, that's right, what I was thinking.
What was the thing? Mm-hmm. Like how long had y'all been together?
Right.
Was y'all just together for 2 months and then stuff like that matters. How long was he? I don't know. I just feel like you just gotta figure out what is best for you in your life. Are you willing to accept the child? How do your future look? Like, are you open to sharing him? Because at this point, you gonna have to share him with the other baby mama. Like, even if they're not together or not, it's a baby. Mm-mm. So it's like,
yeah, that's real. That's real.
But to each his own. That's what I would say.
Yeah.
People make mistakes, but to each his own. That's what I would say. Let me see if we got any more. Yeah, wow, today. We don't have any more. Well, we do, but I'm not going to go over all them questions. Y'all just going to have to wait. But I do want to talk about this. So it says, what questions do you feel like you should ask during, like when you get into relationships with people? And I made a list of questions that I think people should ask.
What's your credit score?
Clap it up.
Yeah.
What number four say on here? What that credit look like? Financial goals. That's what number four was. Number one is, what are your expectations for us? You don't want to go into a situation where you don't know where it's going.
Mm-hmm.
Number one. Number two is, do you want kids in the future? If so, how soon?
Yep.
Some people don't want kids. Is that okay with you? Some people want five, mm-hmm. six kids.
Right.
Depends on that person. So that needs to be a conversation that needs to be had. Number three, what are your religious beliefs? That matters.
Mm.
So definitely ask that question. Number four, what that credit look like?
Hmm.
What your financial goals looking like? Mm-hmm. Like, are we on the same page? Is your credit score a 490? Like, what is your credit score?
Mm-hmm.
Like, we need to understand that. And if we are going to be together, and if it is that, let's work on that now. Number five, family dynamics. That is extremely important.
Yep.
You have to realize that people are a part of their families.
Mm-hmm.
So is that person's family a family that you're willing to deal with? Do they have drama?
Mm-hmm.
You know, things like that. You got to really talk about that type of stuff. So I would say that is definitely one of the most important.
Mm-hmm.
Number six, if they have children, what is the relationship with the ex-BM or BD? Baby mama, baby daddy. That's very important. Is they still fucking eggs? I mean, that's a question that you kind of want to know. What does that look like? You need to kind of know that stuff. Number seven. Do you believe in marriage? Because a lot of people may not believe in marriage and don't want to get married. Why be with somebody and they don't want to get married? Especially if you want to get married. So that's definitely something you want to ask. Number eight, medical history. Definitely want to make sure you get tested.
Mm-hmm.
And just, you know, and when I say medical history, that could mean, you know, physical, mm-hmm. that could be emotional,
mm-hmm.
Like spiritual, whatever. Like, what does your medical history look like? Do you have a lot of trauma? Mm-hmm. Like, did your daddy leave you when you was a child? Like, stuff like that really matters because mm-hmm. when you a child, I feel like it's so many things as an adult that I remember as a child. Are y'all the same way?
Yeah.
Like I remember a lot from my childhood.
Yep. Yeah.
So I feel like that's very important on how you were raised. Number nine, your mental health.
Woo. Woo.
Are you open to counseling? Are you a good communicator? Like, what does that look like for you? If we have communication issues, like how are we gonna fix it? Stuff like that. Very important. Number 10, how important is sex to you? And are you okay with being monogamous? Or what does your ideal relationship look like? Because you can't assume that everybody wants to be monogamous. Some people like to have multiple people. They want to be polyamorous. Like some people may be bisexual. Like you just don't know. So I feel like that's definitely a conversation that you need to have. And people may take it as a joke. Like, that's nothing to really joke about because you want to know who you're getting with, especially when it comes to marriage. Like, you got to know. You got to know your partner. So that's what I would say. Those are my top 10 questions that you should ask someone when you get in relationships. So clap it up for my questions, because I feel like
yeah, Jesus Christ, you had real questions. I mean, you always had real questions. Mm-hmm. Those, they tuning in now.
I asked Ace a lot of questions.
They tuning in
before
now.
Before we got married, and he asked me a lot too. So I feel like that was a good thing. So I hope y'all enjoyed today's show. I wish I could answer a few more questions for y'all, but I'm tired and ready to go home and get in bed.
I've been yawning like a mug.
But I do want to go back to just kind of thanking you all for watching. Shout out to AFM. Thank you, Mo. We appreciate you.
Definitely appreciate you.
Thank God for growth. Thank God for everything in life. Like, mm-hmm. I just really, really thank God. And again, thank y'all to our viewers and supporters. And then I just want to say this, like, y'all, if y'all have been down with us, like, y'all got to stay down, like, stay down with us, because y'all don't understand, like, what, or y'all may not see, like, what we see or what we know. So I'm just asking y'all, if y'all genuinely fuck with us, like, stay down, like, because you never know what the future may look like. And one thing about me and Ace is we're always going to look to the future. We're always going to, like, reach for the stars and, like, never stop anything we do. If we stop something, better believe 10 times out of 10, we got something else that's in the works.
Facts.
So just stay down with Young Married and Liz. Stay down with his
and
hers.
Stay down, man.
Hey, because you, listen, I'm telling you now. 2 years from now, when I'm a millionaire, you gonna wish you would have stayed down.
Talk that talk. So, talk that
talk. Hey, if you want to stay down, if you trying to be on, if you want to be on my yacht, if you want to,
I'm gonna be there.
You, hey, Vi, you gonna be there, because you gonna have your own yacht too, boo.
Hey, I'm trying to tell you.
But I'm just saying, like, stay down with people and, like, support your people, because you don't want to be the type of person that's like, damn, like, I should have did this, or I should have did that.
Absolutely.
When that time come. Mm-hmm. Because just because you not supporting doesn't mean a whole 100 or fucking million other people that are supporting. So don't sleep on us, is all I'm saying. Don't sleep on Young Married and Lit. I'm
trying to tell you.
And last thing I want to do is give you your flowers, Vi. I really appreciate you for coming.
Definitely.
You are definitely one of the women that I look up to, because I feel like your shit is together.
Facts.
And you motivated me to get my shit together. So thank you so much, and I appreciate that.
For sure.
And keep doing what you're doing. I do need to get some of that elderberry syrup.
Ooh, that's been helping a lot of people.
Yeah, I need to get some of that. But yeah, I just want to say thank you for coming to Young Married.
What's your social media?
Yeah,
handle?
What's your social medias?
Vi Broadinax on Facebook, Vi's Life Choices on Instagram.
Okay.
And my health page is Holistic Family Circle.
Yes. I'm in that group, so make sure y'all join that group as well. Mm-hmm. But thank you for coming on the show, Vi. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
We're going to have you come back and talk about the holistic stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
People need to know about that too, but they can look it up when they go to your Instagram and stuff. So that's great. But thank y'all for listening. We appreciate y'all. It's been real.
I should be an LLC. I keep shooters on point with me, just like on CP3. I was up in bush with Wicked Blicky, like on 22G. Tripping out this cyber set. Sometimes I put my mind at ease. Pull up with their.